If the words snackbar and toast are making you hungry, then you might be watching the wrong video, because this is all about the little alerts that pop up from the bottom of your screen in your .NET MAUI application. If you've been doing mobile development for a little bit longer, then you probably already know about the term snackbar and toast. As I already mentioned, it's the little alerts that typically come from the bottom of your screen as if they're popping out of a toaster, right? And I think it originated from the Android OS, but developers have also brought it to other operating systems and other systems, even through the web, I think. While on Android, it's built into the OS and it has all the APIs to do these snackbars and toasts. In the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, we also build it for all the supported platforms. So for iOS, Android, Windows, and macOS. For Windows and macOS, it shows a little bit different. It uses the notification system inside of the OS. But for Android and iOS, it looks pretty similar. It behaves pretty similar. And then there's kind of like a toast and snackbar. They do very much the same thing, but toast is a little bit simpler. So you can just show a little notification message to the user like, hey, this happened. And the snackbar is a little bit more advanced. That one can actually have a little button so that you can also click on something and that you trigger an event for some kind of logic that you want to execute there. You can play with like the fonts, with all kinds of styling things, events that you can hook into. So there is some things to cover here, and I'm going to show you how to implement it right now in your own .NET MAUI application. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a file, new .NET MAUI application. And the first thing that we want to do is, of course, install the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So go over to your Solution Explorer, right-click on your project and do Manage NuGet Packages. And whenever you do, we're going to look for the community toolkit.maui. And we got a couple of things that you probably want to know here. So we have the community toolkit.maui, but also the maui.core. Don't get the core one. That's only the core bits for if you want to do something very specific. Just get the maui one, and that has a dependency on core, but this will have all the stuff that you need to actually go and use this. Also, depending on if you're targeting .NET 6 or .NET 7, there might be a specific version that you want to get. If you're on the latest and greatest .NET 7, you can use version 3.0. If you're still on .NET 6, which is totally fine, you can use version 2.0, right? So that's probably where you want to be at. I have targeted .NET 7, so I just want to install it version 3. I'm going to install that. I want to do that. I want to accept the license agreement here. And whenever it's done, you will get this little README that will tell you, hey, you need to initialize this. So I'm going to copy this line, use MAUI Community Toolkit, and go over to my MAUI program. So let's just close this right here and go to my mauiprogram.cs. And then here you can also see that it pops an error, right? That we detect that you have installed the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, but you didn't use that init line. We use analyzers for that, really cool stuff. So we will give you an actual compile error so that you don't forget. So whenever I put that in here, it's going to add the missing using here at the top automatically. If it doesn't do that, make sure that it's in here. And now we are ready to go. So what we're going to do for this sample, at least, so that you get a sense of how to use this, it isn't very advanced. I'm just going to leave this template intact. But on the button here, I'm going to do something specific. So we have this clicked event set up here on counter clicked, and I'm going to make that a little bit more extensive. So here it kind of like, you know, it sets this message on this counter button, and then it's going to announce it for the accessibility. But I also want to have a little toast and a little snack bar doing this here, right? So what I'm going to do is say string message so that I can catch this string in this variable right here. I'm going to copy this one so that this gets into the message, and then I'm going to say counter button dot text is also the message so that we have the original functionality, right? But now what I can also do is here start using the toast. And it's a little bit funny to kind of use it because you're first going to create kind of like the toast and a snack bar definition. You will see that the APIs are very similar. And then you're going to kind of like show it, right? So what you want to do is here on the static instance, you can say toast dot. We have to import the right using here. So let IntelliSense help us. We need to add using community toolkit.maui.alerts. So let's get that in here. And whenever we do, we can do toast.make. And here there's a couple of things that we can specify. So the toast is the simpler one. That's why I'm starting with this one. And then the snack bar is the more advanced one, right? We'll see that in a minute. And here we can say message. So this is just our string message, right? So let's just put our message in here. And then we can say duration. So this is an enum in this case for the toast, and you can choose between short and long. Now at some point this might be different, but short right now is 2 seconds and long right now is 3.5 seconds. So that's you know, whenever you're doing short and long, you know how long and short it actually is. So let's do a long one, so can see that. And you can set the text size. So the text size is 14 just to make it show up for this screen right here. Let's make it 30, something nice. But here we've only created this toast, right? You can see that this make method will return a iToast, so an interface of this toast object. So we probably either want to catch that, so we can do var toast is, and now we have a reference to this toast, and we can say toast.show. Or I can still influence all the properties that we've just set, right? I can set the text, the duration. I can do a dismiss on it as well, so I can dismiss it from code if that's something that you need. So that's there as well. But probably the thing that you typically want to do is say show. And you can also provide a cancellation token so that you can cancel it again from code here as well. So let's do that show, but you can also make it a one-liner, right? You can just do toast.make and then do show right here, right? So you can make it all a one-liner. You can totally do that as well. Now, if we run this, let's run it on Android first. We will see that whenever we click the button, it's incremented on our little button text, right? And we will also now get a toast that will show us, this is clicked this many times. All right, so our emulator is coming up. Our application is being deployed. And in a minute, we should see our .NET bot waving at us, the infamous .NET bot. And whenever we click the button, then we're going to see all of the things that I've just described. So let's move it a little bit to the side here. And whenever I click the button, then you will see here down at the bottom in a big font, clicked one time. And whenever I do it again, you can see that, it replaces all the time. So that's kind of like a characteristic of this Snackbar and Toast. There can only be one. So it replaces it each time. There's not going to be a stack of things. It will just show this one thing. So that's pretty easy, pretty cool for just a simple notification to the user for like, hey, this thing is going on. So that is the toast. Now let's go over to the Snackbar, which is a little bit more advanced. Actually, before I do that, let me show you how this shows on Windows. It's a little bit harder, I guess. So let's switch to our Windows target right here. I'm going to start deploying it. And I need to get myself out of the way here for a little bit. So there we are, because it's going to show here in my taskbar. And I have the Do Not Disturb on right now. So let me just disable that, because else we're not going to see it here. So let me disable that. And our Windows application is coming up right now. Because this, like I already said, this isn't a concept on Windows. So whenever I click it here, we use the native notification of how that looks on Windows, right? So we show this notification here as if it would show on Windows natively, and that's how it goes. And also, you could see that the notification duration might be a little bit longer here, and I think it might be longer because I'm hovering over it, and Windows is seeing like, hey, there's something going on here. So this shows a little bit different on Windows, and also on macOS, we use the notification stuff here. So that is the little bit of difference here between desktop and mobile. And for iOS, it will look much closer to how it looks on Android. Okay, so that's the toast thing right here. Let me just switch this back to Android, because I'm going to show you the rest on Android. So now let's switch over to the Snackbar. I'm going to comment this out. You can find all the code in a GitHub repository that's down in the video description, so make sure to check that out. You will find that code here, but now I will switch over to the Snackbar. So let's do Snackbar here, and this kind of like follows the exact same pattern. So that's why I'm creating this variable here. And here we can say Snackbar dot make, right? So we have this same thing. And again, we can do message. Let's put the message in here. And you can see this has more parameters, right? We can trigger an action. So by default, if you do the Snackbar, it will have one action button. Actually, it's restricted to one action button because that is the concept on Android. That only allows for one button. So we restricted that on the rest as well, or at least that's like best practice. And whenever you tap on that button, this action is going to be triggered. So just to show you what's going to happen, let's do a little display alert here, which is going to be, I don't know, something like, did you subscribe? And then maybe a little more description to my channel yet. I don't know, maybe that's something that you want to do. And okay, so this is like a display alert. I specify the title and the body for this alert and the okay button, right? So that's what I'm doing right here. So this is what's going to happen for this action whenever I do this snackbar make and you tap on the button that's attached to the snackbar. Then the next thing is the action button text for the snackbar. So it will have a action button and I can give that whatever I want. So you can do okay or you can do yes. Let's make it yes. You can specify your own custom duration for this thing. So instead of like just short and long, you can say, hey, time span dot from seconds, and let's make this 10, just make it very long so that we can see it good. And what else do we have? We have the snackbar options. So if we go look at the snackbar options, I'm not going to focus on it too much right now. You can see all kinds of styling options here. So we can say set the action button font. We can set the action button text color. We can set the background color. Maybe that's a nice touch. Let's set the background color right here and let's set that to colors dot, I don't know, let's set it to red. Red is always good, right? Then we probably also want to set the font color, right? So we'd send the text color is colors.white. Maybe that's good as a contrast to red. So you can set the snackbar options for all kinds of styling things of your snackbar. Now, what else did we have? We have one more. You can set an anchor. So I'll show you that in a little bit, actually. You can anchor this snackbar to another visual element on your screen. I will get back to that in a little bit. Now that we have this, let's go over to our snackbar and do dot show. So let's just do this, show. And this follows the exact same context as the toast, right? So we first create this snackbar through the dot make. We configure all the things. So we're building our snackbar. And then we're going to say snackbar.show, right? So you can call upon that. Now here, our application is coming back up on Android. And whenever we click the button now, we will see something very similar to the toast, but a little bit more styled and with this action button right here. So there we are. Let's click on this click me. And here you see it, the red one with the white text right here and the yes button. And whenever I click the yes button, then that action will be invoked and we see this display alert, right? Did you subscribe to my channel yet? This is your signal. Go click that subscribe button. So that's how it shows. And if I click it again and again and again, you can see it replaces, right? That's the same concept that we've seen before. So this is a little bit more advanced. You can actually trigger an action. And where you would typically probably use this, where you see it a lot, is that maybe you send an email or send a message and you get a couple of seconds to undo that, right? So the button would say undo and you will undo that action. That's a typical use case for this stuff. But of course, anything that fits in your application can be done like this. Now, what makes this a little bit more advanced is that the snackbar has, the anchor. So let's start with that one. And I think I might be able to hot reload this code. So let's go to our main page.xaml and give our image a X name. And by giving it an X name, I will give it a variable name, which I can reference from the code behind. So let's make this .NET bot image, just some name that we can reference it by. And now I can use this from our code behind here and use it as the anchor. So whenever I do this, and I hope this works, I didn't prepare this, so you should never go off script. I'm going to use hot reload, and that will hot reload our code. Oh, it actually says that it doesn't support this. So let's rebuild and apply changes. It's going to redeploy it for me. So what I did now is use this variable name, .NET bot image, that I've set here on this XAML. And I use that as the anchor. And what's going to happen now is that this snackbar is going to show as, somewhere around this visual element on the screen. So you can attach it somewhere. It's not, you know, you cannot always let it come from the bottom of your screen. You can also anchor it to another visual element. So whenever I do click me now, you can see that it comes here at the top of this image, right? And I can also do it on this label, the other label, or this button, right? So you can make it show up somewhere inside of your visual tree of your application, wherever it makes sense, so that you can play with that and style it and make it part of your application. So that's one thing that you can do. The other things that you can do, I won't go into that in great detail right now, is hook into events. So that also is kind of interesting because we only have one instance. We can just use that through the static instance right here. So we can say snackbar, and you can have a show event. You can have a dismissed event. So whenever it's shown or dismissed, you can have a property which is shown. and you can get the current state, like is the snack bar shown right now, yes or no. So you have a couple of things that you can use right here and make that snack bar and toast work for your .NET MAUI application. So this is pretty cool, right? Just another tool in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. And you can make very powerful things with this. I already mentioned like the undo scenario or just popping a little message to the user like, hey, we auto-saved your document or we did this thing. This is a very small, easy to use API, but can be very powerful for your user experience. Thank you so much for watching again one of my videos. If you have any ideas on what I should do next or you have any follow-up questions on this video, please let me know down in the comments. Don't forget to click that like button so this video will spread to more people on the YouTubeverse and we'll learn about .NET MAUI and this Snackbar and Toast. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already and maybe check out this playlist for even more goodies in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. Check out this recommended video just for you and this button to check if you've actually subscribed. See you for the next one.